All right. Mass releases have become common in WWE, and this has led to people hating WWE even more. So let's look at some of the possible reasons why WWE is firing talent so often. Number one, the obvious budget cuts. WWE is in its most profitable year, and this has been the trend year after year. They are just gaining profits all over the place. They are bleeding money at this point. So budget cuts is the lamest possible reason they can give. Also, WWE is expecting a profit of $315 million in 2021.
What?
And still they need to release talent. It's all the more surprising. And they are letting good talent land in the hands of AEW or any other promotion. I mean, good talent like Karrion Kross, Keith Lee, John Morrison, Braun Strowman, Bray Wyatt. They have let go Adam Cole and Daniel Bryan. There are so many more. So giving the budget cuts as a reason is bullshit, okay? So that's a reason we cannot accept. So if WWE is releasing so many talent, it means that they're happy with a few people. And that's reason number two. They're happy to have just 4 to 5 guys main eventing every month, and they will just rotate with those 4 to 5 guys. Say for example, if Seth Rollins is main eventing this month, then the next month it will be Kevin Owens, and after that it would be Drew McIntyre, and after that say maybe Finn Balor. So they will just rotate these 4 to 5 guys in a year, and then that's it. The year is over, the pay-per-views are done, and they are happy to have 4 to 5 guys main eventing in WWE with the same matches, with the same stipulations, and there would be some point that we would get frustrated by this, seeing the same people over and over again. Reason number three is a failure to connect to the viewers. Okay, so look, whenever a wrestler receives a push, it means that WWE is banking on that wrestler, and WWE expects that this wrestler gets over with the crowd, be it as a face, be it as a heel. Now, the wrestler is more often than not given less TV time. They just give him stop-start pushes. The prime example here is Ricochet. He has received stop-start pushes all throughout his main roster career. So WWE needs to understand this. If a wrestler has to connect with the audience, then you better give him time to grow, time for that TV exposure, and not stop start pushes. It should be consistent. The push needs to be consistent, okay? So failure to connect to the viewers, failure to connect to the live audience may be one of the reasons that the talent is getting released. Reason number four, WWE is going to be sold off. Now, there are multiple reports saying that WWE is going to be sold, and these are just rumors at this point. But in the past year or so, there have been multiple rumors about WWE selling off to Disney and all this kind of stuff. Now, this can be possible with WWE laying off so many talent backstage as well and on-screen talent. So I don't know, guys, because WWE, after receiving so much profit year after year, I mean like $315 million they are expecting in 2021, I don't think there is any necessity for Vince McMahon to sell off WWE. And speaking of Vince McMahon, reason number five, Vince McMahon is just creatively dead. Okay, so you need to understand what I mean by creatively dead. Vince McMahon looks over at everything. He looks over the promos, he looks over the matches. I mean, he is on the ears all the time, on the referees, on the commentators and everything, okay? Vince McMahon looks over everything. And I feel that it's time for Vince McMahon to take a step back and hand the reins over to maybe Shane McMahon or Triple H. Because let's be honest, guys, Vince McMahon isn't going to be any younger. He's, I believe, 78 now. So he is fit, okay? He is healthy, but creatively, he is not as sound as it needs to be. Yes, 1980s, 1990s, even 2000s, he dominated creatively. I agree on that. But now it's time for Vince McMahon to take a step back, because it's not working, guys. Vince McMahon's ideas are not just reaching to the fans, to the viewers. And maybe what Vince McMahon wants from the wrestler is not able to provide it. So hence he is or she is getting released. So, I mean, I don't know, guys. Vince McMahon is just creatively dead. That's what I feel here. The next reason is Nick Khan. So, this is an interesting one. Ever since Nick Khan entered in WWE as the president, mass releases have become all the more common. He takes the blame to himself, but look at the explanation he gave to Ariel Helwani. I don't know if there is one explanation for it. Ultimately, what's looked at? Is this one person for us going to move the needle now or in the imminent future? We signed a dozen new talent. We are always looking for what's next. We live in the present. We live in the future. We don't live in the past. And he also said that there is a collective of us keeping at WWE. There is one boss, that's Vince, as we all know. Between Bruce Prichard, who oversees the entire creative process, Kevin Dunn, who oversees all of our productions, Stephanie McMahon and Paul Levesque are all involved in these decisions, with ultimately Vince McMahon making the final decision on everything. Now, we all knew this, okay? The final call is off Vince McMahon, but Nick Khan has emerged as this major, major power player in WWE. A person who has no background in wrestling, and he's releasing talent. The next reason is horrible booking, okay? So horrible booking hurts the wrestler's momentum and the connection is lost with the crowd, because all that the audience remembers is that the horrible booking he received at this pay-per-view. A prime example here is The Fiend versus Seth Rollins, how it ended at Hell in a Cell 2019. Everybody still remembers that. Even recently, Bianca Belair's 26-second title loss to Becky Lynch, that was a squash, and people remember that. People remember the negative things, and horrible booking is one of them. So one day you are the champion, but one or two months later you are jobbing to an opponent, and before you know it, you're gone from WWE. And the final reason we are looking at is age factor. Now, this is a very recent update that WWE is looking to offload all those wrestlers who are over 40 and are looking for younger talent in their 20s. So this may be done in hopes to capture the younger audience, but if that's the case, Hit Row shouldn't have been released. I mean, raps easily catch the eye of the younger audience, and if WWE wants that 18 to 49 demo to be up, then they need people like Hit Row in WWE. I mean, that release didn't make sense for me. And there is more coming, guys. The releases are more coming. Those who are 40 plus in WWE, they need to be aware, especially AJ Styles, Finn Balor, Kevin Owens. They are on the radar next. So that's it for this video. If you like this one, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and if you want to know why WWE sucks, then click this video displaying on your screen right now. I will see you guys in the next one.